Bonk Your Mama Cup.
This is the map testing room. Yeah, hello guys! Fantastic! I edited the wrong room. Woo! And we're starting with the very good map here. Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, the first round is starting. We play 3 rounds on each map. In each single round, you can gain points. Point limit is 1,500. And yeah, let's see who's gonna win in the ending. Let's follow the first round on Chris, his POV. What is Chris gonna cook? Chris always doing good in these kind of cups. So I expect him to be there. And he is looking good in the first round. Elkon showing what he's capable of in the very first one. Followed by Kopro, Trulé, and now also Chris. Chris having a really awkward line here, I think. Oh, but Elkon not having good speed. And is it actually Chris overtaking everyone? Is he gonna get a good last drift? He is. Is he gonna win it? Chris for the OK Boys. Yeah. Second round. Let's follow Limpan. Limpan also a player who improved a lot from Sweden in the past. At least he's cooking on the Nadeo maps on map 23 in the past 2 campaigns. So let's see what he can do in a format like this, where it's about learning possibly very dank maps fast. He ate a lot of grass here, pulled a little bit of a cow. But still looking good for him here. We have the same candidates as before. Kanchika, of course, also playing. Kanchika, always really good at these tournaments as well. Oh, Limpan trying to go for the nose slide, but he wants a little bit too much. It looks like Elkon is gonna win the second round here. He's even going for a diagonal jump to not have to release here. And he's doing a 39.7. Very good time by Elkon here. And I would say we're just gonna follow the final round on Kanchika's POV here. Let's see what he's going to be able to do. Not having the greatest dirt entry. Airtime at the entry and at the exit. But now a wall ride coming up. Something Kanchika is of course very used to as a full speed player. So he also gets good exit speed here. Good speed into the bobsleigh. But quite a bit behind the top players. But let's see. This part here seems to be the decider. And Kanchika having it beautifully. Overtaking like 10 people. Elkon once again cooking. He's actually going to win every single round. Kanchika, most likely with a fourth place here. Yup, close round again. And well played by Kanchika. And the next map is called, oops, you need to put the CD in your computer. And it looks, okay, actually looks very simple again. Lars, for example, now, being a good contender. He did miss out a little bit on map 1 because he joined late. Just as in the beta edition, funnily enough. But yeah, let's see. Oh my god! What the fuck? Okay, that is a speed check and a half. Nobody made it. Holy shit. Okay, 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 okay. That is a speed check and a half. It didn't look that difficult, to be honest. But that is gonna kill a majority of the players. You know what I'm gonna do? You know what I'm gonna do? Camera 7 and just spectate the fiesta. But that is the rule of the Bonk Your Mama Cup, guys. Stuff like this will not get filtered out, so let's see who is gonna survive the jump of death. Oh god. Okay, many people did not survive it. Some people barely survived it. And quite a few also got it clean. And it once again is Elkon 21 winning a round here. God damn it, man. He is cooking. Lars also survived it. Same for Kopro, Shadowcrancer, Chris as well. But yeah, with that jump, we are gonna see quite some DNFs. I am sure about that. Blee also not really able to make the jump. Aaron neither. Oh my god. Yeah, people are in the mud. The thing is, it's also not respawnable. People are even going wide out in the start in order to make the jump. Interesting strategy. But yeah, it's important to get the gear here and then to not lose it. Kopro very inside. I'm not sure if Kopro can make it clean with this, but he barely does. Okay, this time it also looks like Elkon is not going to be the winner of the round. Shadowcrancer with a really good start, having airtime into this here. And maybe Elkon can actually snipe. Will Elkon snipe? Shadowcrancer going for a drift, and it's once again Elkon completely dominating. And here we are now. This looks a little bit more interesting again. See me lol. Hashtag 1. I see a reactor. I see... Wait, what is this? Wait, oh my god, this looks giga difficult. Stop, what do you have to do here? Is it a bounce? Oh my god, no way. There is no way, little bro. Yeah, we are gonna try it, guys. Let's see. Let's see. But that is the rules, guys. There is no exceptions in the Bonk Your Mama Cup. Shit is dank here. Okay, come on. Somebody will finish. Nope. The thing is... Nope. Benja? Yeah, what is...
Nope.
What exactly nope. do we do in the finish? Oh! Elkon? Oh, Elkon, look close here. Oh, Aver Agergi, close. Nice, finished! Holy shit! Nice, got it! Next up, DBD Cup number 17. All right, let's see, Shadowcrancer. What is he gonna be able to cook? Is he... Did he figure out the route? Does he know what to do? Or not? Has a solid start, not the greatest speed into this section here. Does he know he has to release? Optimally, you want to release before you jump off, because otherwise you need to release in the air, and in the air, releasing is slower. Good start by him, good release. It is actually Lars and Elkon fighting here mainly, but also Copro, Chris, and now also Kubu are in the mix here. So let's follow Chris, his POV for the finish. Awkward jumps by almost everyone, but it seems like Lars is gonna bring home the first round, and as I said, this is a certified Lars map. Well, let's see Nice. Nice, the only person to finish the previous track. The only person to score any points on that. So let's see. Not having the greatest drifts here. Does he know about the release though? That he has to release before jumping off. Yes, he does. And with that, also overtaking quite a few people. He is jumping very far though, so he has to release big time and losing out on a lot here. Let's see Kanchika. Bit of a full speed ending, so maybe Kanchika can snipe someone here. Not looking too great though. Can barely clock in the top 10. Very awkward landings, and Elkon with the full crash in the checkpoint. Lars with a second place, Copro in first, but that bonk cost Elkon a lot of points. So let's see. Mr. Kush, what are you cooking? I hope we are gonna make it until Cup of the Day. I really hope we can, but yeah, we should have mostly short maps, so it should be fine. Oh, Kush not knowing about the... actually still solid release. Release is early. That is definitely better than late. So he is doing good. And do I see Chris doing really good here? Chris actually fighting for first in this round, but it seems like Elkon... After mentioning Elkon for not doing too great in the previous round, he's of course gonna absolutely dominate the next one. Kanchika sniping Chris for second place. That is a 43.7 by Elkon. Very good time. Deserved first place with that. Lars still in fourth, so also Lars scoring good points here. So this is actually a remake of a tier, either of a Trackmania 2 map or a Trackmania Nations Forever map. But probably TMNF, because it's the Nations Converter. People will have to drive this map blind in the ending, which is making it even more exciting. So you gotta be careful with what's happening here. The warm-up is not long enough to scout the entire length of long maps. So let's see. Lars. One of the best players when it comes to fast learning formats. So I'm looking forward to see what he can pull off. So very important. You wanna get this exit nice, otherwise you might yeet away and have to release. So let's see. Okay, good line by Lars. Low exit, but also Jan van Achten actually getting really good. And there's Elkon coming from behind with a lot of speed. Are people aware? Jan van Achten with the... with the touch. But Lars with the release. Oh, very awkward corkscrew. Is he gonna be able to survive it? I hear a car. It's Kanchika, but it's not enough. And Elkon also really close. We have three people within... 300th of a second. Next round, let's go a little bit lower into the field. Let's see how people are doing. Let's just spectate Blee for a round. Let's see what Blee can do. Going very wide in the start. Doing an emergency drift here. But he is overtaking a lot of people because we have quite some touches. So actually not looking too bad of a round for Blee, but now the hard parts are coming up. Will he be able to withstand them? Wall right line, low exit, and actually really good performance here by Blee. Surviving this very hard line. Bit of a drift, small touch, maybe actually good, because with that low speed, it will be way easier to survive this wall, right? You see how high some people are jumping, and we also see crashes here. So Blee in 44th right now. Let's see, is he aware of the last turn? Yes. Oh, he's doing a drift again, where it's not necessary, so losing out on a lot of possible speed. Oh, the edge here! Oh, you're almost dying, but Blee seems like quite nicely surviving the round. 36th place, right ahead of John C. Okay, who's gonna win this round? Eyes on Elkon at the moment. Kanchika is doing really good on this map. Not surprising, it is a... Oh, Elkon! With a big boy crash! Will he even make the looping? Oh, barely making the looping, but he's of course out for the good points. Kanchika is doing a pre-drift to get a lower wall ride line, but look who is even faster than him. It is Kübel to the Chris. Is Chris gonna be able to full speed the last turn? It is looking pretty good for Chris. Oh, Kanchika almost getting the clip, and Chris with a sick round winning here with 49.5. Good focus by Chris. And what is this? Skyfall by FunkyTM. Plastic full speed-ish. So once again, rigged for Kanchika. He's just so good at reading maps, and he is... I saw that as well, Lars. Lars thought he could go for a cut here. But yeah, probably not a good idea. And also having low speed, so let's maybe put the eyes on Kanchika. Never mind. Eyes on Elkon maybe? Never mind. Kubu maybe? Fuck. Okay, everybody's in the mud. let's follow 2-2 now. What about that? 2-2. Okay, you can overjump this first edge. The exit speed out of this is gonna be very important, as well as a good line here, because otherwise you have to oversteer. Elkon got it really nicely, but also 2-2 got it pretty nicely. Tried to do a drift cancel, didn't work out, but still better exit speed than his direct opponent, Elkon. But they are not alone. Shadowcrancer, where is... Yeah, that's exactly what I meant. 2-2 was not really aware of the rest of the map here. Lars actually was, and he's also getting a nice risky finish in second place. Shadowcrancer in first. Let's take our eyes onto Shadowcrancer, who's also not very often playing these kind of formats, of course. Not sure if I've ever seen Shadowcrancer in a fast learn format, to be fair. But for that, he is doing really good. Nice speed slides here. Is going for the risky, and Elkon is completely missing the risky finish. That was not even close. All right, next map. A short one. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a water climb. So let's see. We're gonna follow the action here with camera 7. Perfect map for that. So let's see. How many people are gonna finish at all? Oh, we have the first people climbing. It looks like Kush in first. Looks like Kush in first. Lars overtaking though. AR also in the lead. Is Lars gonna stay in first? Yes, he is. AR in second. Kush in third. Kanchika also making it. Kubo making it. Blee making it. Blee with a fifth place. Holy shit. Damn, okay, Blee, good focus, sick performance by Blee here. Haha, he's happy, yeah, usually. Most people build dank shit. So having maps like this, yeah, is to be expected. Okay, Aaron had a good start, but lost a little bit. So AR overtook him, Aaron in second though. We have Jan van Achtern, Trulé, Gepo Kakaravi, Kanchika and Lars as well, not too bad with the points. Kush here as well. Where is Elkon though? Chris also is gonna finish. Limpan on his way to finish as well. Would be important points for him. Is he making it? Yes, he is, I think. Storyfy might be the last one to finish, but he lost it on the last second. And there's Elkon. And Elkon actually with a DNF. And that is crazy. Look at Lars and Kanchika. They are fighting like crazy. Next up, short 03. Reactor. Okay, a Riolu skip in the ending. Alright, looks like a drivable map. Dot dot dot. Waiting time again, as always. But there we go. Let's see. Is Elkon gonna go for Le Shortcut? He almost went for the start touch. That was very close to the wall. No, he's not going for it. And but Aaron almost overtook. Oh my god, 1,000 between Aaron and Lars. Holy good race. But yeah, with that, good points for the top three. I think they are all gonna get finalists here. And the thing is, Lars and Kanchika will most likely get finalists in this certain round already. So on this map, we might already have the winner of the second edition of the Bonk Your Mama Cup. Oh my god, Elkon! No way! Elkon got the Omega Slow-Mo! Holy shit! Elkon lost 9 seconds. Brute. He got Slow-Mo so hard. But the thing is, if Elkon wins the round, he is 1 point behind. That is so sad because he literally got scammed. Esport ready plug, yeah. Okay. Lars is going for the normal round, but people are skipping and look at Elkon. And Elkon is actually at 1,499. There is no freaking way, little bro. There is no freaking way. Elkon got so fucking scammed. Elkon, if he didn't get the slow-mo, he would have won the tournament at this point. Like, he literally lost it to Nadeo. Definitely a map Lars can close it out on. I think we're gonna follow him in the normal camera, of course. So let's see, will he do good? Will he be able to finish it? Or will he not? Drift here, good exit speed. Overtaking many, but Elkon, Kanchika and Limpan ahead. Kopo as well fighting. Wow, Lars with a giga good drift. He might be first at this point, but...
No, 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 no.
Elkon is cooking like a chef and a half. So if Elkon does not throw... Elkon, it's all on you. It's all on you. If you wanna win the cup, it's all on you. And he survives it and is denying Lars. And that is an insane run. So. Okay. Oh, it is again Mr. Elkon. He would honestly deserve to win on this, to be fair. He played really good. He got scammed. So let's see. Is Elkon gonna hold his nerves or is he gonna troll?
Elkon with the full crack!
No way! Elkon got the Omega slow-mo! And Elkon actually with a DNF. Oh, Elkon! With a big boy crash! Will he even make the looping? It looks like we have a winner, Elkon with a 28.6. Really good time again. GG Elkon. Deserved, deserved, deserved.